trail by 19 with 2:39 to go. Coming up for the Raptors, as I mentioned a little bit earlier, their next game not until Wednesday, so obviously the day off on Monday after the back-to-back, but then an extra day on Tuesday. They return to action on Wednesday against the Detroit Pistons. Now, I would say, on paper, that's still one that would favor you. But that said, Detroit hammered the Raptors, just dissected them about a week and a half ago, blowing them out by 24 points. Raptors gave up 129 points to the Pistons, and Toronto could still be undermanned. That said, Nick Nurse did say before the game that he was hoping to have at least a couple of the five players sidelined back in his lineup by the time Wednesday rolled around.
And it sounds like they're going to trickle back in a little at a time, Eric, because of the way the days and the protocols work. So eventually, like I said, you're going to get them all back, but anybody coming back would help the way things are going right now.
Technical free throw right now being taken by Levine. Knocks that down, puts the lead for the Bulls up to 20. Watson to Harris, over to Thomas on the near sideline. And Matt Thomas knocks down the triple, his first bucket of the game. 2:20 to go.
San Antonio, Tuesday, Wednesday. Harris missed on the drive, and then Williams stumbles a blocking foul against Watson. So Williams at the line, and Bill, he's going to have an opportunity to have a season high here. He's this season high with 20.
I mean, his career high.
Well, it's his rookie year, so I kind of go with his season high, but yeah. I get it. So, and we found out the last time, we have to ask Jeff Van Gurten, the last time the Bulls have had 9 double-figure scores. And Williams' first attempt popped out. Nope. Arch coming in. Valentine coming in. Marketing leaves. Thaddeus Young will leave. So Young getting his first start of the